Hello everyone, my name is Auro, I'm a full-time indie game developer. Let's go play some games made by my viewers. Okay, this game is King's Gauntlet Chess Revolution by Tall Grass Games. I like the main menu screen, I think it's a pretty cool way to handle it. So you don't actually need to like open a new window, it just pops up on the right. And I checked the tutorial and I think it's also very nicely handled that there's, you don't need to like enter a game session to go through it, you can just look through it. And yeah, these animations are really cool, I think. Very nice way to handle it, I think. Nice job. Okay, let's give it a try. I'll go with normal mode against the computer. Ooh. Okay, so it starts right away. Okay, it's pretty intense. What? What's going on? Ooh, I died. Okay, a new try. Let's see. Okay. I won. Nice, I guess. I wasn't really focused on the enemy. And hey, since this is a 1v1 game, I figured I get a mystery player to play with me who is currently off screen, so let's give it a try. Oh, and my mystery player is maybe not the most experienced with games, so I will try to give a bit of an like a handicap for her. So since the game is so hectic, it's kind of hard to grasp the basics at first. But if you play it a bit, you will soon notice how it works. So you shoot your opponent with this, like, whatever it is, plasma bullets, whatnot. And by doing that, you will charge your, like, power meter above the character. And when your power meter is full, you can summon these chess pieces that will move along the, like, normal patterns from the traditional chess game. So yeah, basically they activate when you run near one of them or one of your existing chess pieces gets near one of the enemy chess pieces. So okay, let's see, my opponent has a nice array of chess pieces here, so let's see if I actually start playing the game myself. It's kind of tricky because there are so many chess pieces that you kind of need to be careful where you move. But my tactic is just trying to avoid everything and spawn chest pieces randomly, so hoping my opponent will make a mistake before I do. And yep, very nice timing because I was just about to die. And then you can also collect these coins on the map, and when you have 3 you can kind of like conquer your enemy's chess pieces. Activate that there and... Okay, cool. I think this idea is really cool. It's a like very unique combination of genres, and I really like the chess pieces. It's like pretty much everyone understands how chess pieces move, but when it's combined with this like very hectic gameplay, it's a fun combination, but I don't know if it's maybe too hectic because there's not really too much room for like tactical elements, trying to like outmaneuver your opponent with the chess pieces. Maybe that comes with time when both of the players are more skilled, so there's like more consideration going on how you play the game. Okay. Very nice job, my mystery player. I was thinking that design-wise, I'm not really too sure about the like this main method of charging your meter, this like plasma bullets, whatever it is. I think a nice alternative could be, for example, to have a like bigger impact attack that is on a cooldown. the gameplay would be a bit more slow paced due to that, so you have more time to think like where to actually place your chess pieces and not just like keep spamming them as soon as you can. I don't know, that's just an idea, but maybe I would give it a try. Oh yeah, and I probably didn't mention it, but the visuals look really cool, I think, like it fits the style really well. Okay, let's try one match where I will really try to try hard and beat my opponent as fast as I can. Maybe that will be fun to try. Okay, yeah, that was a fun match. I think the basic gameplay, while fun, can get quite repetitive quite fast. So I think there should be like more variance in the game. Maybe different game modes. Oh yeah, by the way, my mystery player mentioned that the game is like fast to learn, so it's a good thing if a person who doesn't really play games that much feels like the game is easy to learn, so yeah, that's a good sign. Okay, it seems my opponent got stuck in the like in the corner. I know a way of getting my friend here out of this predicament. I think it's called a bishop, I think. Let's see what it does for those who don't know how to play chess. Oh yeah, that's how we do it. One thing that I think might be a challenge with this game is that it's a very fun game to play with a friend. I doubt it will be too much fun against a computer, but with a friend it's fun. But that of course comes with the problem that you will need to have a friend to play with. And while I'm sure that most people have at least one friend, there's always the consideration if, like, do they like these types of games and will they have enough time to play, and so that kind of cuts down your player base, I think. If someone knows that, okay, my friends are usually busy, they might not give the game a try, even if they would want to. So I don't know if there is a good solution for that. It's not really unique to this game. It's a common problem with games like this. Could be one option to make it really fun to play alone and then just make it more fun to play with a friend. Of course, that's easier said than done, so yeah. The game seems fairly polished to me already, so that's also a big plus. But yeah, there are of course those challenges I mentioned that you will need to tackle, but I hope you will manage to do that. If you like this game, it's on Steam, so you can go add it to your wishlist or try out the same demo that I just played. And next up is Chambers of Devious Design. Wait, that's my game. How did that end up here? Actually, funny fact, did you know my dog, Luna, gets a treat for every new wishlist? Yes, it's true. And she's very, very hungry. Please, help me keep her happy. Okay, moving on. Okay, this game is PolyCore Defense by Torx Game. Right off the bat, I think this menu screens and all this here is very smooth. I like this like small animation that you have here. Small touch, but really cool. I think it adds to it. Arrival. Okay, and I can select an ability. Invulnerability. All right. Cool looking turrets. I think one small improvement that would be to like have the tooltip appear a bit faster, especially as a beginner. I don't know anything about this turret, so I just want to see the stats and compare them, but there's like a half a second delay before the tooltip appears, and the like damage values can only be seen that way. So okay, I'm guessing the miniguns are probably a pretty good starter turret. I think this should cover the most amount of like road real estate, right? Oh yeah, the tree blocks the turret. Okay, yeah, that's pretty cool. Okay, I'm ready. Okay, more money, more turrets. Okay, so I just realized that you can actually upgrade the turrets also. That's cool. So let's get some upgrades going on. I'm trying to make this like middle turret here, my MVP turret. I'm gonna get all the upgrades available. Oh yeah, fully upgraded. Let's go. No, I'm done for. Shoot. I wasn't good enough. I think the firing speed would be nice to know as a number also. So you could do some math here and see which has the like highest damage per second. Okay, I think I need to try a different tactic. I think my problem was that even though this position covered a lot of real estate, so to say, but my turrets were only active a like part of the wave. Oh, by the way, and I think it would also be cool to see these upgrades when you're choosing a turret somehow, because I don't know, for example, if I can use a range extender with this turret, and that would be a valuable information with the placement of this turret, I think. I think it would be cool to have an even faster speed setting, because the, at least in this map, the early levels are quite easy, so I just want to breeze past them, and there's not really so much you can do within the waves other than like spend money on upgrades. And now I noticed that, okay, so you can set the targeting mode also with the turrets. Okay, that's very cool, so you can optimize and plan out how they attack. Okay, I don't think I'm smart enough to optimize this, but that's a cool setting. I think it would also be nice to have like the turret stats listed somewhere here. So for example, how much damage it does and attack speed and all that stuff. And I think the upgrades currently are not quite clear, because this minigun does 12 damage, and then this upgrade says that okay, you will deal even more damage, and there's 14 there. So I assume, yeah, it will boost your damage by 2, but I could also understand it so that this boosts your damage by 14. I like that you can choose which turret you can unlock next, and also I like that it's only 3 choices, so it's not completely up to you, but you still have a choice. Yeah, I think that's definitely the like kind of the best way to handle this, so great job. Although when you pause the game, I think you should probably stop all the sounds, because I can hear this like enemy noise looping in the background while I'm choosing my turret here. Not a big problem, but yeah, nobody will get past my massive minefield here. Damn it. Oh well. Okay, so now that I got levels, I can also buy some upgrade points. That's cool. Some more progression. That's always very nice with these type of games. I think the game is really fun to play, and it's already very polished from what I can tell. I noticed that you're planning to release it early next year, so yeah, I think you're at a really, really nice point of development, and I think you have a great game here on your hands. I forgot to mention at the beginning, but I really liked that the tutorial was kind of like integrated into the game, so I didn't need to play a separate tutorial map. One thing I think you might want to think about is that, are there too many waves per level? With that many waves, it takes quite a while to beat a level, which can be good. It's very satisfying to beat a like level with 40 waves, but if you fail, it can seem like a waste of time to like spend, I don't know, half an hour or more to like try the level and then fail, and then you need to start from all the way from the beginning. And also, I don't know if you're planning to like have this game on mobile. If you're planning to go on mobile, I think the 40 waves is too long, because people don't play mobile games that long usually. I like tower defense games, but I haven't really played any recently, so I don't know how your game compares to the competitors. That's always one aspect that it's good to know, that even if you have a really great game, you need to do something better or something unique compared to your competitors. But regardless of that, I do think you have a great fun game on your hands here, and I wish you the best with the release. And hey, if you like the game, it's on Steam, so you can add it to your wishlist, or there's actually a demo also, so you can already give it a try yourself. Okay, this game is Destroying the Asteroid along with Unfair Hurdles by Mukesh Pramod Shukla. Okay, I think I have kind of grasped the gist of this game. So if you touch the walls, you will die and you will need to start from the beginning. So basically you're incentivized to go really slow in this game. And I think design-wise that is maybe not very ideal. What I would do design-wise would be to completely take away the like hitting wall destroys you thing, and I would try improving the like control of the ship so that there's a throttle and then you can just like aim it different ways, and then maybe you could make the like walls really bouncy so that if you hit a wall your spaceship kind of like flies like everywhere. I think that could be like a fun mechanic without having you to completely retry the level every time you hit a wall, so you don't need to move like this granny speed here without actually seeing anything. And maybe then you could have a like time limit per level, so you need to go fast, but you will also need a lot of finesse with the controlling of the spaceship. I don't know if the map keeps repeating or what, but I think I've seen this same things quite often. Yeah, and the fourth set of droppers, I have seen three set of droppers already with the exact same arrangement. First asteroid zone. Okay, so yeah, I got my first asteroid, and I think if I remember correctly, you need to collect two asteroids. So I'm halfway to finishing the game. If I remember correctly, this was your first game, so I do congratulate you on getting this far, but if I give my honest feedback, I think there's lots of room for improvement design-wise and with polishing different things. Like the spaceship doesn't like, it's not actually a spaceship, it's just a like moving model kind of, and yeah, the environment is not very pretty looking, and the menus also could be improved visually a lot, I think, and yeah, lots of different small things. I feel like currently this is kind of like a demo of a game idea. But of course, yeah, if it's your first game, it's it's hard to be like very good at everything. So yeah, now that you have gotten this far, I think it's good to keep going and improve things. If not with this game idea, then the next game. Okay, so it seems I hit one of the droppers, so I'm back now to the first asteroid. But I think I had my fix of this game. The game is also on Steam, so if you feel like you want to give it a try yourself, it's already available for purchase. Although I do have to say that I don't think the price point really matches the quality that I just saw in the game. Okay, and then we have UNPLUGGED by Omid Jafari. Okay, cool, there's a background story to it. Okay, cool. Okay, so I assume you cannot move in this game. Okay, the animations and graphics I think are really cool. By the way, is that Comic Sans with the text? What? Okay. So I just pressed up and it seems like I'm back alive. Okay, and I just realized that I actually have a gun also, and shotgun. Cool. So how do I... What? Oh. Overall, I think the melee is a bit more satisfying. I think the gun effects could be a bit better. This mode is cool. When you press shift, you go to this like slow-mo and zoomed in. Yeah, that's a that's a cool effect, I think. But what I would really want to do is move. Like, not just wait here until they come and beat me down, but like, run up to them and beat them down. Ah, so it just got them now. This is kind of like a rhythm game. I think I found a bug. Okay, do I have unlimited pistol ammo, I think. Damn, my man spit like a closet. The visuals in this game were the highlight for me. It's a unique, cool-looking style, and for the most part, the effects and animations looked nice and felt satisfying. I did notice some issues with sprites getting cropped at weird places though. I think the gameplay was very basic, but it was still enjoyable to play for a while. But I think not being able to move your character is a big deal breaker though. That's what people will expect from looking at your game, and they will be disappointed when they realize that that's not possible. Having a looping linear collider, for example, could be an easy solution if you don't want to spend time on level design. It's far from an optimal solution though, but being able to move in any kind of way would already be an improvement. I think the story was cool, although quite short. I enjoyed how the story progressed, kind of like reading a comic book page or two between the actual gameplay rounds. As for improvement ideas for story, I think you should switch Comic Sans to something else. That's just not a font people would take seriously. There were also a lot of typos in the text, so getting someone to proofread your text would be an easy improvement. There were also some bugs I found quite easily, so spending some time on QA and then fixing whatever you find is a good idea. Overall, I think with a longer story, some improvements to the core gameplay, and with squashing all the bugs, I could see the game selling decently as an enjoyable small story-driven experience. If I remember correctly that this was your first game, I think all things considered it's a very nice effort. Especially nice job on the unique visuals. But yeah, if you want to try out the game, it's currently available for purchase on Steam, and I will have the link in the description. But hey, that's all the games I had time for in this video. I hope you enjoy watching this as I still have a lot of submissions to go through. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.